had given to opportunity for presenting the lecture. Also thank Dr. Premalada Madam and Dr. Sudhakar, so other organizing committee members, Prabhat and other research scholar, Professor Lab Assistant Air Person, the Govind Raj is also helping me at the time for manufacturing of column setup as well as persona. So I give this introduction. Municipal solid waste landfill liner is given as for topic. Already sir has introduced me. So is a waste management is for given for you for 1 week workshop. So I have chosen as a municipal solid waste landfill liner. So some basic introduction of the municipal solid waste landfill liner. So before dumping any waste, we need for some prevention or precaution needed. So most probably have a clay soil. It's a soil is highly progressive nature put on the ground. So after waste poor water may be hazardous waste or municipal waste water may be put in top side. The liner consists of a clay soil. In olden days, most probably a clay liner would be preferred. The depth of liner is 1.2 meter. So, 1 feet high. Put on layer and make it for compaction. Operates for the municipal solid waste. So, it is clay liner is consists of one or more layers. Cohesive soil that have been compacted to achieve permeability. To purpose of clay liner in landfill serve the barrier between waste material and environment by preventing seepage against the landfill. So you prevent the leachate is nothing but a solid semi-solid liquid, so it is highly concentrated. Say for example wastewater, you see that apart from wastewater you have another 50 or 20 times more than the heavy concentration. So due to the entire solid waste is degrade for moisture content as well as other atmospheric parameter, have a liquid form is directly penetrated to ground, the whole groundwater may be contaminated. So in and around area, it's not for few meter, even the few kilometer also have a contaminant. So we need minimum need for put on some liner before that solid waste. It absence of impermeable natural soil, compacted mix of bentonite PVC membrane as per foundry sand, drilling mud, tire shed and the geosynthetic liner has been used for barriers to fluid transport. So if you know that even the natural material nowadays is a scarcer one for in even river sand in Kaveri Delta there are a lot of issues will be there, as well as for clay soil. So nowadays you get it, you think about that 1.2 meter right for few acre, if not possible for laying that. So you are alternative the material widely using for advanced technology is called as a geosynthetic clay liner. We will see that. So I have some collected literature review of, there are two parameters. One is for a civil engineer expert in a geotechnical engineering, the soil characteristics. Next one for an environmental side. So in permeability and the consolidation, they are very very important. So how much the leachate is penetrated in the ground, that is called as a permeability. Other name is called as technical hydraulic conductivity. So next for soil interaction the leachate, I have collected in literatures. So for finally we are validated whether finding in the groundwater. So main objective of my studies on geotechnical properties of the clay and the clay microsilica composites, studies on changes in permeability of clay liner material with the clay microsilica composites using an incremental loading consultant test. So an environmental expert found that adsorption coefficient of clay microsilica composites, solute transport single clay liner system that mixes of microsilica. So as well as for the studies transport for composite clay liner system, there are two or more clay liner system. using the GCL, geosynthetic clay liner. So it is a ideally planned will. So this is for most probably have a trapezoidal shape. This one is a trapezoidal shape. The landfill is consist of the liner. This is called as a liner. So in this diagram here, you see that for a liner, there are two liner. One is primary liner and second one is a secondary liner. It is a solid waste dumping. So we are closed after four down 20 or 25 years. The landfill is entirely closed. So due to reactions take place, the leach chart is generated. The leach chart is also collection pipe here is also there. You see that. It's a leach chart collection pipe. So as well as for somebody monitoring well needed for after closure of the landfill. It is a typical conventional landfill. So nowadays is most probably European and US countries, this type of landfill not used. So its other name is called bioreactor landfill. So its advanced technology will be there. So all in the same like that in auditorium, the closed room, already have planned to design for entire closed site. So only the inside somewhat you are just like the door open, that same like that you are solid waste dumping. All will be closed. It's not any gases in outside. So I have chosen the material for clay soil. It's most probably its name is Kalathur series in Tamil Nadu. A soil atlas is called Kalathur series. So it is dark brown and very calcareous fine textures as per ASTM methods are collected. Microsilica is one of the material is byproduct of ferrosilicon ions. So next one for Indian standard strand is for a compare of things for direct CS test. So next one for geosynthetic clay liner is obtained from Ashpura Limited, Mumbai. Municipal solid waste leach chart is collected here for Narimangalam, opposite of SIT in Trichy Tanjore Highway, in NIT around 6 or 7 km towards Trichy. So it is a FTR clay soil collection site. So any diagram, easy representation for come from India and Tamil Nadu and operates for and through particular locality. It's a Trichy district and again you are finding that particular locality is I did in PhD here, so nearby area which clay soil is available. I searched it from soil atlas and found that here for nearby Kallani. Most probably NIT students, you know that Grand Anicet is one of Emperor Chola is constructed in around Kallani, 2 or 3 kilometers from Kallani. We collected the clay sample, so it is for one lake nearby area in Kallani. I collect that. So most probably you know that some standards, the collection of soil. So before 2 feet in top soil removed and we collecting. So this is a nature of adjacent nature, swelling nature. It's normally a clay soil, is very swelling nature. As far as a geosynthetic clay liner, so it's a commercial material. It's available from, at that time it's not available, it's imported, but nowadays it's a lot of Gujarat and Maharashtra, a lot of industries would be there. It's you think that 1.2 meter height for a clay soil, here only required for 2 inches. Just 5 or 6 centimeter needed for just laying that. So it is a material. So it is for laying before placing the soil, put on a GCL. So here also there is some different view under different angles. So this is for JCP for leveling the solid waste. It's a cross section of GCL. The GCL is consists of bentonite. Bentonite is a highly coarse nature, clay soil, is sandwiched material. So you know the jute, most probably in West Bengal, the jute will be there. The same like type of material here also is for sandwich. This is a sandwich. This is for clay soil, this is for jute. Just like that.